The Voice in Speech and Song, Chapter 13, Love, Sympathy, and Kindness. Tact, not severity. The Savior never suppressed the truth, but he uttered it always in love. In his intercourse with others, he exercised the greatest tact, and he was always kind and thoughtful. He was never rude, never needlessly spoke a severe word, never gave unnecessary pain to a sensitive soul. He did not censure human weakness. He fearlessly denounced hypocrisy, unbelief, and iniquity, but tears were in his voice as he uttered his scathing rebukes. He never made truth cruel, but ever manifested a deep tenderness for humanity. Words like a balm. Multitudes who were not interested in the harangues of the rabbis were attracted by his teaching. They could understand his words, and their hearts were warmed and comforted. He spoke of God not as an avenging judge, but as a tender father, and he revealed the image of God as mirrored in himself. His words were like balm to the wounded spirit. Both by his words and by his works of mercy, he was breaking the oppressive power of the old traditions and man-made commandments, and presenting the love of God in its exhaustless fullness. Sympathy in both speaking and listening. The life of Christ was filled with words and acts of benevolence, sympathy, and love. He was ever attentive to listen to and relieve the woes of those who came to him. Multitudes carried in their own persons the evidence of his divine power. Yet, after the work had been accomplished, many were ashamed of the humble yet mighty teacher. Because the rulers did not believe on him, the people were not willing to accept Jesus. He was a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. They could not endure to be governed by his sober, self-denying life. They wished to enjoy the honor which the world bestows. Yet many followed the Son of God and listened to his instructions, feasting upon the words which fell so graciously from his lips. His words were full of meaning, yet so plain that the weakest could understand them. Assurance of truth. The words of the Master were clear and distinct, and were spoken in sympathy and tenderness. They carried with them the assurance that here was truth. It was the simplicity and earnestness with which Christ labored and spoke that drew so many to him. Comfort and tenderness. Even in his childhood, he spoke words of comfort and tenderness to young and old. He was an example of what all children may strive to be. In his words and actions, he manifested tender sympathy for all. His companionship was a healing, soothing balm to the disheartened and depressed.